special Dream Friday. I thought I'd change it up a bit today and not have a speech, but an interview. I had a conversation with a young circler the other day that I wanted to share with you. I've asked May Holland, who some of you might know is one of our new guppies in customer experience, to join me today. May's only been with us for a few months, but she has made quite an impression. Let's bring her out. May Holland. Well, hi, May. How are you?
Terrified.
Don't be nervous.
Easy for you to say.
All right, May, we have all seen the sea change footage from the other night, but please describe what happened for us.
I committed a crime. I borrowed a kayak without the owner's knowledge, paddled out to the middle of the bay, and I wasn't wearing a life jacket.
Well, I'm not sure that's exactly a capital offense, but you did risk your own life. So, May, do you think you behave better or worse when you are being watched?
Better. Without a doubt.
And what happens when you're alone and unobserved?
Well, for starters, I steal kayaks.
She's a natural.
Seriously, I do things I don't want to do. I lie.
When we spoke the other day, you had a way of putting it that I thought was very interesting and succinct. Could you tell us all what you said?
I said that secrets are lies.
Secrets are lies. Go on.
Secrets are what make crimes possible. We behave worse when we're not accountable. I was my worst self because I didn't think anyone was watching. I thought that I was alone.
So, what did you see on this kayaking trip, May? Was it beautiful?
It was. There was almost a full moon, and it felt like I was paddling through liquid silver.
Sounds incredible. But there's no record of any of it.
Not outside my own memory.
No. Okay, so now here we get into something personal. As you know, I have a son, Gunnar, who was born with cerebral palsy. And though he's living a very full life and we're always trying to improve his opportunities, he is confined to a wheelchair. And he can't walk, he can't run, he can't go kayaking. So what does he do if he wants to experience something like that? Well, he watches video. He looks at pictures. And much of his experiences of the world come through the experience of others. When he experiences the view of a circular climbing Mount Kenya, he feels like he's climbed Mount Kenya. When he sees firsthand video from an America's Cup crew member, he feels in some way that he's sailed in the America's Cup too. And these experiences were facilitated by generous humans who shared what they saw with the world, my son included, and there are many others out there that are just like Gunnar. Now, does it feel right to have deprived them of seeing what you saw, May?
It doesn't. It feels very wrong. It was selfish. When you deprive others of experiences like the ones I had, you're essentially stealing from them. Knowledge is a basic human right. Access to all possible human experience is a basic human right.
Thank you, May, for your candor and your consummate humanity. Now the best part. In the interest of sharing everything she can with the world, May has some news.
From now on, I'll be wearing a modified sea change camera at all times. I'm going fully transparent.
Well, maybe not in the bathroom.
I'll be starting immediately.
That's right. May will be the first circler to share every single second of her work and her personal life with the public, so let's give her an even bigger hand.